make me feel so alive.
Hello there, welcome to VAE Live. This is the voice of arts and entertainment. My name is Ethan, and today we're joined by a very special guest brought to you by Asia Times Square, K-pop star Kevin Wu.
Hello everyone, Kevin Wu here.
This show is brought to you by Asia Times Square, so thank you for that, and we're going to go ahead and get started with the interview. So my first question for you, Kevin, is knowing that you are a popular K-pop artist, can you please tell us what brought you into the industry?
Wow. So for me, as a Korean American, I grew up in San Francisco, California, actually, and I lived there until I was 15. And then I just had a huge heart for Koreans and Korean culture, Korean music. And that is what really intrigued me to visit Korea at such a young age. And I auditioned to become a K-pop boy band, and it's been history ever since. Yeah.
So I know in K-pop, dancing is a very an essential part of the industry. So who comes up with your choreographies?
I mean, it differs between each song and performance, but these days I've been working with a very talented choreographer named Eileen Kim, and she's a part of this huge, very well-known dance team called JRV. And I had, a great time collaborating with her for my new single, Got It. And yeah, I'm just like really happy to work with different teams around the world. I have had the chance to work with people in Korea, Tokyo, out here in America. So yeah, I mean, for me, dancing is a huge part of my career and just life in general, because I just love dancing, whether it's on stage or off stage. And one of my biggest inspirations was an artist named Rain. Rain and Seven, those are the two big guys who really inspired me to be in K-pop.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So besides dancing, is there anything else that you do to keep your mind and your body fit?
Yes. So these days I've been doing a lot of yoga. Yeah, I think it's very, very crucial for anyone to set aside time, whether it's in the morning, daytime, nighttime. It doesn't matter when, but I feel like yoga helps me focus and have a more calmer, peace of mind. And I think that's a great way to, hone in into your physical state and even your mental state.
Right.
So yoga is a big one. I've been writing a lot of music these days, so that's been helping me too. And we're still kind of in this pandemic, of a very awkward time. But when I am at home, I love just writing my emotions onto music and onto ideas.
Yeah, he sings, he dances, he writes music. What about instruments? Do you play any instruments?
Instruments. So I grew up playing the guitar. I was a praise leader at my church, actually, when I was growing up. But didn't really get to focus on guitar too much throughout my whole idol career, but definitely want to pick it up very soon.
Any other hobbies that you enjoy doing besides the few that we listed?
So I'm currently based in LA, and we have a lot of great hikes. And I'm a very outdoorsy type of guy. I love going on hikes. I love going to the beach. I love driving. And some people might dread driving because, you get stuck in traffic. But for me, I honestly love driving. And that's why I also incorporated that into my music video for Got It. You guys can see me drive down Malibu, which is really pretty.
Yes, everyone, please go stream his newest single, Got It.
Yeah.
So now let's talk about your music. How many albums have you released? Or if not any albums, how many singles have you released? And you tell us the names?
As a soloist?
As a soloist. In your career in general.
In my career, I feel like I've released over 50. maybe even more. But yeah, I've had a very long career. It's weird to say that because I'm still young. And it's weird when people call me a veteran in K-pop. It's a weird, I guess, label that I guess I had to get used to now. But, throughout my years, I've probably released a lot of albums, a lot of singles, but as a soloist though, I've released 3 singles, and 1 mini album. It's kind of like an EP.
Right.
In Korea, we call them a mini album.
Yeah.
And Got It is like my 4th single, actually. Yeah. So, very new. I would say I'm kind of revamping my career, out here in the States, and it's a very exciting time for me, and I've got a lot of more, music in store for you guys, so stay tuned.
Yes, we're very excited, and we're very happy to have you here in the United States.
Thank you. Yeah, especially in Texas.
Especially
right?
in Texas.
My
yep.
first time here.
Yeah. And so what are your plans for more music coming in the future? Any albums, more singles?
I mean, right now it's I haven't announced anything yet, so everything's in the works. I can't announce anything just yet, but I can tell the fans and the audience that I am working on more music, especially more English tracks for sure, because now I am transitioning over to the US market, and I do want to do more events out here, like the one I'm doing this week in Arlington, Texas, and it's going to be a very exciting concert for me, the first concert ever since the pandemic. So yeah, hopefully I'll get more music out there, and I'll definitely want to tour around the States and globally if I have the chance.
Yeah, so it's your first time here in Dallas, Texas, Texas in general.
Yeah.
What are you most excited about, besides your concert, obviously?
Of course, yeah. Number one is my concert, meeting my fans. It's just really surprising because not everyone is from Dallas that's coming to the concert. There's people all over Texas that are driving in, even from neighboring states. I have a few fans from Korea that are coming.
Wow.
I have a fan from... even Latin America that's coming. And it is just really, really, very flattering. And I'm very appreciative to all the fans who are, joining this concert for me. What else am I looking forward to? I'm looking forward to the barbecue in Texas.
Right. Yeah. That's one of the many things that we do well around here that we're known for.
Yep. And I heard that in Dallas, you guys do the briskets.
We do. Brisket is a very big thing here.
Oh man. I think I have to get some briskets after the show tomorrow. Yeah. Anything else you recommend for me?
Barbecue is big.
Barbecue.
I would say, we actually have a lot of different cuisines all over the world, from all over the world. So,
yeah.
Yeah, everything is pretty good over here. Everything's bigger in Texas, too.
Of course. So right now we're located at Asia Times Square, and it's my first time here, of course, and I'm just mesmerized of how big it is and how much food, how much very diverse Asian food here. So can't wait to check that out. And thank you, Asia Times Square, for having us here.
Yeah, so we, for the past couple of years, have been in a very awkward situation with a pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
How have you dealt with it, with your music and personal life?
Wow, deep question. I think we're all still trying to navigate our lives throughout this pandemic. But for me, I was very fortunate to not catch COVID. And let's keep it that way. For me, my main focus was to stay healthy, for sure, and my family. I felt the responsibility to keep my parents, safe. And so, yeah, it's been a pretty relatively healthy year for me. And other than the COVID situation, I really wanted to just focus on my social media and connecting with my fans. And I feel like, it was a mutual, thing where like we needed each other. We were all stuck at home, of course, as many of us were. And I really wanted to, help the fans kind of engage in a way that we haven't ever before. I'm very active on social media, but throughout the pandemic, I started TikTok, and I've also shown a lot of my life, online. And I felt like the relationship between me and my fans, who I call the Clovers.
Clovers, okay.
With the K, so it's Kevin Lovers.
Ah, okay.
Yeah,
Kevin
Clover,
Lovers,
right?
Clovers. That's your fandom name.
Yeah.
Very
yeah.
clever.
So me
clever
and my,
with a K.
Kevin Clover, yeah, I was going to say that. Me and my Clovers, we just had this very, very close bond. And I'm just very thankful for all the support, despite, all the adversities that we've been through.
So there are a lot of people out there who are inspired, and they would love to be influencers on social media, as well as artists.
Artists.
Even K-pop artists. Do you have any advice, recommendations for them?
Oh, great question. Yeah. I feel like in this day and age, there's just so many opportunities for everyone. You guys could just find which platform resonates with you the best. Because every platform has its own personality, I feel like. Like TikTok, you know, there's a certain humor and I guess this algorithm that, you know, happens. Also Instagram, YouTube, Twitter. And there's just lots of ways to get noticed. Where from in my age, and I feel old saying this, but back in my day, I felt like we had to seek out for opportunities. Mm-hmm. We had to go in-person auditions and find managers. But nowadays, everyone is their own broadcasting station, I feel like. Everyone has their own power. Everyone has their own audience and reach. So what a great time for you guys to share your talent to the world. So I really advocate you guys, you know, putting yourselves more out into the online world, and you'll find something for sure. Yeah.
And lastly, Asia Times Square strives to promote culture while preserving tradition. They have invited you to perform here in Arlington, city of Dallas. What do you have to say regarding this opportunity?
Yeah, I am incredibly thankful for this opportunity. I want to thank Asia Times Square for inviting me to Texas to perform for all the K-pop fans out here. I know there's a lot of K-pop fans in Texas, and I've never had the chance to visit, so thank you for having me. And I want to thank Texas Live for hosting the venue. And, you know, I mean, it's an incredible time, especially for Asian Americans, because we're getting a lot of recognition, especially in TV and film, and of course, K-pop, right? Mm-hmm. Just a lot of love coming from the States. And yeah, I'm just very, very honored, to be a part of this Korean wave, as we say, the Hallyu wave. And it's my passion and my goal to just keep pushing forward and being a representative for more Asian American artists in the future. Yeah.
Yes, well, we certainly are very excited to have you here, Kevin.
Thank
the
you.
Clovers are also very excited.
Yes.
Tomorrow, his performance at Texas Live. His concert, Kevin Wu concert. So thank you so much for coming and joining our show at VAA Live, the voice of arts and entertainment. Once again, my name is Ethan, and thank you for watching.
Thank you. See you soon.